अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट पोलियो वायरस। पोलियो वायरस काजेस पोलियोमायलाइटिस। ओके, दिस इज़ अ वायरल डिजीज विच मे अफेक्ट द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड काजिंग मसल वीकनेस एंड पैरालिसिस। सो पोलियो वायरस कॉज अ डिजीज नोन एज पोलियोमायलाइटिस। दिस इज़ अ वायरल डिजीज विच मे अफेक्ट द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड and cause muscle weakness and paralysis. The word polio means grey and myelin means marrow, indicating the spinal cord. Are derived from the Greek word, poliomyelitis is a disease of anterior horn motor neuron of the spinal cord and brainstem caused by poliovirus. Poliovirus literally means grey spinal cord inflammation. Now we will discuss about some important properties related to poliovirus. This virus localizes in the anterior horn cells of the spinal cord and certain brainstem motor nuclei. It is contagious. Usually it spread from one person to another. It is only harmful to humans. There are three serological types based on its antigenic determinants. How it is transmitted? It is transmitted by fecal-oral route. It replicates in oropharynx and intestinal tract. Humans are the only natural host. In this picture, you will see its transmission. It is a highly contagious infection. It spread from the fecal-oral route. Primary mode of transmission is passage of the virus in the stool to the mouth of another child. Means if there is not good hygienic habits, then it could be transferred to the mouth of other child. Can also be spread through saliva or droplets from sneeze or cough. So child in this first picture, child is excreting virus in the stool and does not wash hands after using the bathroom. So virus will transmit to the all the bathroom area. Okay, then virus could also be transferred to objects from the hand of that infected person. Virus transferred to another child through the hands of infected person or the other child if may contact the objects infected with the virus. It can also get from all those objects. Virus transferred through ingestion of contaminated food. And then there will be the next cycle of infection will begin. Now talk about the pathogenesis of poliovirus. It replicates in oropharynx and small intestine. After its replication, the virus will spread through bloodstream into the CNS. It can also spread retrograde along nerve axons. In the CNS, poliovirus replicates in the motor neurons located in the anterior horns of the spinal cord. Death of these cells result in the paralysis of the muscles innervated by those neurons. The virus also affects the brainstem, leading to bulbar poliomyelitis with respiratory paralysis. In infected individual, the immune response consists of both intestinal immunoglobulin A and humoral immunoglobulin G to the specific serotype. Pathogenesis is not very important for you people, but for your understanding, I have just added two slides of it and a little bit more. Multiplies in reticuloendothelial system. Its portal of entry is mouth. From the mouth in oropharynx, it starts multiplication. Then there will be the primary or minor viremia. After primary viremia, there will be secondary viremia. Viremia means there will be the presence of virus in the blood. From there, it will transfer to the spinal cord and brain, then multiply in the neurons. Then lesions are mostly in anterior horns of the spinal cord, causing flaccid paralysis, and it destroys them. As in this slide, I will show you the virus replicate in the oropharyngeal and intestinal mucosa. Then virus spread to the tonsils and multiplies in the pair patches, cervical mesenteric nodes. After there, virus is absorbed into bloodstream and spread into internal organs and lymph nodes. Viremic phase. No further spread of virus, asymptomatic or mild febrile undifferentiated illness. or virus spread to the spinal cord and it will cause the paralysis of the muscles. There are few clinical findings that it appears in many phases. Some of it will be the asymptomatic infections that are inapparent and quite common. Some of it are abortive poliomyelitis, that is the most common form, in which there will be the mild febrile illness that is characterized by headache, vomiting, nausea, sore throat. Most patients recover spontaneously in abortive poliomyelitis. Okay. In third form of the poliomyelitis, there will be the non-paralytic poliomyelitis. That with in non-paralytic poliomyelitis, what would be the symptoms are aseptic meningitis, fever, headache, stiff neck, and it will resolve spontaneously. Then there will be the fourth form, that is the paralytic poliomyelitis. That is a very severe form, in which there will be the flaccid paralysis, there will be life-threatening respiratory paralysis occur, and there will be the painful muscle spasm. In non-paralytic polio, there will be flu-like symptoms that include sore throat, fever, tiredness, nausea, headache, stomach pain, and asymptomatic. Paralytic polio, there will be the paresthesia, there will be meningitis, means inflammation of brain. There will be paralysis of the muscles and weakness in the arms, legs, or both. You can see the appearance in these picture. The patients having the poliovirus infection or poliomyelitis. You can see the muscle weakness. There are very thin muscles of that side which is paralyzed. Of the affected area is paralyzed. Okay, poliomyelitis clinical manifestation, there could be spinal polio, there is bulbar polio, and there is bulbospinal polio. Spinal polio is mostly in 79% of the cases. It usually involves the legs. And bulbar polio, weakness of the muscles innervated by the cranial nerves. And in 19% of the cases, there could be both. Okay, there could be spinal plus bulbar polio. Mostly it infects the children. Most cases are asymptomatic and there would be non-specific symptoms in 5% of the cases. And there will be the CNS symptoms. Travels in blood, retrograde travel in neurons, replicates in the motor neurons of the anterior horn of the spinal cord. It can cause meningitis, post-polio symptoms, nerve dysfunction progresses decades later. Okay. There are two types of vaccines present. One is IPV and other is oral. OPV, IPV is inactivated vaccine, and there is live vaccine, that is OPV, oral vaccine. Okay. Now we will talk about the lab diagnosis of this virus. So for the lab diagnosis, we will collect the specimen, and specimen will depend on the clinically apparent disease. Like if we can take the throat swab, we can take stool sample or CSF. Then we will perform serological test and CSF test for this purpose. Okay. How to prevent from poliomyelitis? There are two sort of vaccines present. One is oral polio vaccine and the other one is inactivated polio vaccine. Okay. You need to know the names of these two vaccines. Adults should get vaccinated if they had never before been immunized against polio before. The first dose can be anytime, the second dose 1 to 2 months later, and the third dose 6 to 12 months after the second dose. And children should be vaccinated with 4 dosage of IPV, a dose at 2 months, a dose at 4 months, a dose at 6 to 18 months, and a booster dose at 4 to 6 years. Okay, this is the adult dosage of IPV. Okay, in this slide, this is the, you can say, the summary of all that we have done so far. Polio is a viral disease that transmits through contaminated food and fecal oral route. Okay, can only be prevented through immunization. It can only be prevented through immunization. Children under 5 years old are particularly vulnerable to the polio virus. Okay, how to develop immunization? We have vaccines available. There are inactivated polio vaccines given by injection. Amount, there are three. We will give 3 doses and 1 extra. How we schedule it? 2, 3 and 5th month old with additional dose given at 18 months old national immunization table. Okay, vaccinations are critical to protect infants from preventable disease. The other way, how can, there are some sort of complications and symptoms that we have already discussed. Patient will feel headache, fever, difficulty in breathing, tiredness, muscle atrophy, central nervous system attack, limbs paralysis. That is the most common symptoms of poliomyelitis. How can we prevent this? Prevention is because of the, if we wash hand with soap and water after using the toilet, ensure good sanitation facilities, if we drink boiled and bottled water, use caution with undercooked food, and peel fruit to remove the dirt and germs. Okay, means we need to protect ourselves by following good or proper hygienic conditions or hygienic habits. We can prevent this disease. Okay, so thank you for watching, and I hope you may have good understanding of this lecture. Allah Hafiz.